Hey guys, Roby here with Divi Engine, and today is a pretty big day because Divi just released, well, Elegant Themes just released Divi 4.17, which includes Divi Cloud. Now, some of us have been in the know for a minute on this and knew it was coming, and here it finally is. Now, the way they market it is that it is basically cloud storage for your layouts with a big roadmap of features to come. Now, they say, think about it kind of like Dropbox, and it's really no different than any type of cloud storage that you already use, maybe for your pictures, maybe it's your iPhone backups, whatever it is, you are already using this technology. Now, how much does it cost? If we go to the Divi page for this on the Elegant Theme site for Divi Cloud, and you scroll all the way down, or maybe you just click this button here, you get to the pricing. Now, they've got two models. One's for monthly, that currently is discounted 20% and comes in at $6.40 a month, currently discounted from $8. So who knows when they won't let that go up, but at the moment, this is what it is. For that, you get unlimited storage, unlimited items, and unlimited websites, which is actually a pretty sweet deal if you think in the terms of cloud storage. And if you're an agency or a freelancer, this is a, you know, the cost of doing business, and it's not that bad. Now, yearly, you can get a further discount of 40%. That makes it $4.80 or $57.60 billed annually. And you basically get the same stuff. So that is what it is going to cost. Now, some of the use cases that come to mind, and you'll see some of them on the roadmap, is of course storing the layouts, but also code snippets, Divi settings, purchase layout packs. No, but with that, I see one snag is that, let's say the author of that layout pack updates it, you're going to have to go probably through a painful process of going into the cloud, deleting the layout, adding the new version. That could be, you know, a little bit cumbersome and annoying, but that's me. Anyway, so we talked a lot about what this is and kind of like how much it costs and all those things. Why don't we take a look at how we utilize it? But first, we got to upgrade. So I'm going to show you how to do that. Okay, so first things first, here I have an install that has not yet been updated to Divi 4.17. You see that denoted by this little red dot right there next to updates and up here. I'm going to go click on that. And this is going to bring me to my update screen for all Divi or WordPress updates, plugins, and so forth. And here is Divi, and you can see I have not updated this install in a while. Shame on me. So let's go ahead and check the box and click update themes. And that is all we have to do here. Now, to start using it, you need to sign in to your Elegant Themes account. And I'm just going to show you a quick hack on that. It's just you go to a page, and here I've got a Divi Cloud demo page. I'll go into that. All right, so I'm going to hit the plus here. And here you'll see the Divi library, number one, and all the pre-made layout packs. But now it's got this new sign in to Divi Cloud button. So we're going to click that. And then you're going to go ahead and enter your details here. And I have mine, and the screen will probably blur so that you guys don't all use my credentials here. But there we go. And bam, I'm logged in. There we go. And it's just loading up again. And now we can see that Divi Engine's logged in here. And when I go to my saved layouts, you'll see that it's got this My Divi Cloud area, and that is where this is going to live and breathe. So let's take a look at how we're going to be using that. And I'm going to be doing that on a different install, and I'm going to be importing from there to here. So let's go take a look. All right, so here I've got a layout that we built in one of my tutorials before. It's pretty okay. It's got some cool features on here, and you can check that link in the description to go and build this yourself with just Divi. But I kind of like this layout, and maybe I'm building a site for a new hamburger shop, and I kind of want to start off with this hero section. So what we're going to do is I'm going to go into the edit section and edit the page for this. And now here, I'm already signed into the Divi Cloud. So all I basically need to do here is click the Save to Cloud button right here, and give it a name, and we will call this Burger Site Hero Section. And this is going to be a page layout, so I just want to say that this is a page layout so I understand the context to import this with. So all I need to do is flip the Save to Divi Cloud button right here, and Then it'll pop up with some options here. Here I already have a hamburger tutorial category that I created. You can create new ones right down here. I'm just going to select that. And now I will just create a tag. I already have one for image module. And I will say header page section, just to kind of identify it. But you can add any tag you want. You can organize it any way you want to. So I'm going to go ahead and say save to Divi Cloud. And there you go. That's it. Okay, so now we're going to want to import this on our other install that we have going on. So I am just going to click over there. And here's that page that we looked at earlier when we signed in to Divi Cloud. So I'm going to refresh it really quick just to set my nerves at ease and make sure that it works. I am going to go and click the plus button here. Now here you'll see that we're logged in already as we did earlier. I'm going to click on your saved layouts. And here we can see my burger section. I actually saved it twice by accident. That's what happens when you click the button too many times. So this is how you delete one. And you can handle all of this straight from Divi Boulder now. So I'm going to delete that one. Boom, you're gone. And there we go. Now, the reason I'm seeing this right here is because this has been imported or saved to the cloud as a page layout. If I go out and I want to add a module and say add from library, you'll see that earlier I created this one where I just saved that image. And what's awesome is it generated a thumbnail for us. So that makes it super easy to use. But let's go out of there again. I'm just going to go and click the plus sign for the page. I'm going to go to my saved layouts and I'm going to click on this. Yep, that looks good. That's what I want. And I'm going to say use this layout. And there we go. That's all there really is. Now, if I go and save this page and go take a look on the front end, we'll see that the header is different because I did not import my theme builder header. But here we are with that exact same layout that we created. And now we can easily go use this on any site we want without having to transport a bunch of JSON files and nonsense like that. So let's talk about the feature roadmap that they have going on here. And I think this is going to speak to a lot of those use cases I mentioned. They're going to let you put theme builder templates in here, Divi Cloud libraries, theme customizer settings, which is awesome, Boulder presets, code snippets, theme options, third-party integrations. Now, that's going to be huge for body commerce and Divi machine users that you can utilize our products from the Divi Cloud directly. So no more having to drag a bunch of stuff around and suffer in silence. You can do full website exports in the future, child themes, plugins, fonts, colors, and Divi Boulder settings. There's just so much in there. It's hard to comprehend what they're going to be doing here, but it's going to be awesome as they roll out more features. Now, one thing that I forgot to mention is that you don't have to pay for this service. You can get up to 50 items stored in Divi Cloud for free with your existing Divi license with Elegant Themes. That's very cool of them to give us that. I can see a lot of smaller freelancers where that would be sufficient, where they just have a base, you know, template that they use and they replicate that and they have a niche market, like I mentioned before, maybe restaurants. It's a really great way to use this service from Elegant Themes. Now, guys, like I said, this is really awesome for the community and certainly signals a move towards more of a service model for Divi going forward. My guess is that with time, the lifetime membership will probably go away as things do, and Divi is going to evolve with the market, and Divi will become an online platform, not too different from WordPress.com or, you know, blogs or stores hosted there, where everything lives in WordPress. And that takes care of the hosting, it takes care of all the other services, the themes, and everything that's included. But there's no reason to panic, though. We see with that third-party integration of Divi Cloud that places like Divi Engine, we're going nowhere. We are definitely part of the evolution. We were aware of this change that's coming, and we are super excited for it and how it's going to interact with our plugins and our layouts and all the different things we do. Can you imagine having access to our layout packs for Divi Machine or Divi Body Commerce straight from the Layouts Cloud with Divi Cloud? That is just incredible. So this is a great move on their end, and it shows some long legs for the Divi theme and a bright future ahead. That, my friends, was our quick overview of Divi Cloud. I sincerely hope that you enjoyed it. Now, don't forget to show your love by liking this video and subscribing to the channel. Bye for now.